又有问题的话啊，等一下一路讲的时候有问题，麻烦大家就是可以啊在聊天里面打，不然等一下忘记。OK， 今天是4月28号 ，OK， 我们讲的是工人权利 ，OK。我们今天就是请到 Community Legal Service， 就是写费城社区法律服务的啊 Rihanna 啊，他就是来讲关于这个工人权利的 ，OK 啊，我刚才在聊天里面发了一个登记表，麻烦大家可以就是啊去这个登记一下啊，人就让我可以跟报告一下 ，OK， 拿一些资料啊。Okay, 然后呢啊，这个就是我们 PCDC 的 mission statement， 就是我们就是非牟利的为社区服务的，我们是在华富啊，在唐人街的 ，OK， 主要就是让居民商家都可以保持他们的利益，还有就是建一个住宅，还有商业的社区啊，这个是我公司 ，OK， 啊，现在啊，我可能明天也要回去 ，OK， 啊，然后这个是我们做的服务，我们是有不同的服务，最主要的就是开发这个啊经济的啊。实用房 ，OK， 还有就是可能啊，就是有一些青少年项目啊，啊，就是关于社区的服务，我们都是有做了。啊，这个是我深建的代下啊，我们深建的 ，OK， 啊，主要我们现在的有三个点，就是第一就是啊，家庭，还有就是啊，商业的支持，然后就是还有就是那些啊被啊种族歧视的和受害者，我们就是有帮啊。支持的 ，OK 啊，然后提醒一下投票，麻烦大家如果是公民啊 ，OK， 记得是6月2号需要去投票。如果是还没不还是公民还是还没有登记的，麻烦你就是啊去登记5月18号，还有半个月就需要就啊截止去登记就投票了。你不登记没办法投票，麻烦大家跟其他人讲讲，我们的确有很多人的去投票 ，OK。啊，然后就是 census 也是了 ，OK。现在我们费城是越来越远了 ，OK。之前只差几个百分比，现在呢，我们费城才43%，一半都没不到啊 ，OK。非常重要，就是叫家里的人、朋友的，就是麻烦填一些这个 census 这个人口普查。啊，这个是昨天、今天刚刚更新的，全国是53%，滨州是54%，滨州来讲的是比较好，可是费城呢才43%，就达不到标。OK， 啊，这样子就是等于如果之后啊那个联邦把资源分配的话，可能费城就得不到很多了。OK， 啊，这个是我们两个 flyer， 就是说一个啊住房基金的 flyer， 还有就是这个啊高中生的。OK， 啊，两个问卷调查，希望大家也可以有空的时候可以去做，就是啊就是。一个高中生的，就是一个移民健康计划的啊一个 survey，OK，OK，、okay? okay? 然后还有一个就是财务的 ，OK， 所以麻烦大家有空的话可以帮我填一下 ，OK， 我其实在微信里边也有发的 ，OK， 这个情绪健康呢 ，OK， 我们其实有两个墙，有两个 workshop， 是下个星期五，还有下个星期一 ，OK， 可以看一看我们微信里边的海报。啊 ，OK， 啊，如果是有受到种族歧视的 ，OK， 麻烦大家 ，OK， 可以填一些表，让我们可以就是跟市政府还是啊都去反映，就是说有这些问题 ，OK， 啊，那么基本上我今天我就是啊，现在我就是把时间交给啊 Rihanna， OK， 啊，我就是交给他去讲了。我有一点点的翻译，可是不是很全的。OK， OK， so Rihanna， you can introduce yourself.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. My name is Rihanna DiClementi, and I'm a staff attorney in the Employment Unit at Community Legal Services of Philadelphia.
OK， 他说他是叫 Rihanna， 他是啊，好高兴过到啊过来这里啊，就是跟大家讲，然后他是社区啊法律服务费城的。的那个职员律师 staff attorney.
Today I'm going to be talking a little bit about workers' rights during this COVID-19 crisis.
他今天主要就是讲一些这个这个病毒期间的工人权利是有什么。
You can go to the next slide.
Yes, I get it.
So I'm going to think about two different categories. What you should do if you're out of work due to coronavirus, and what are your rights if you're still working?
要有两点，就是讲，就是如果是因为这个病毒失业的话，该怎么办呢？ 还有如果现在还在工作的话有什么权利
Next slide.
Okay.
If you're out of work due to coronavirus, you may be entitled to certain benefits, including unemployment compensation, unpaid wages, pay for sick time, and other federal relief.
他说：“如果你是因为这个病毒失业的话，你有可能有权利了。第一可能是可以申请这个失业金 ，OK， 也可以就是把你占的，可是还是拖欠的工资去拿回来。也有可能就是一些还有没有用的那个病假是付钱的病假，还有就是其他的联邦的补助。
And I'm going to talk briefly about each one of these things.”
他会很简单讲一下每一样的。
So first is unemployment compensation. If you're out of work or losing hours because of coronavirus, you may qualify for Pennsylvania unemployment compensation.
他第一样讲的就是这个失业金的。OK， 他说如果你是因为没工作了还是工时减少的，你可以申请这个宾州的失业金。
This includes if you've been temporarily laid off, or your workplace is closed, if you've been sent home due to coronavirus symptoms, or if you were fired or quit because you refused to work in unsafe conditions.
Okay, 这个包括就是说因为还有如果你是拒绝上班是因为这个病毒
So we encourage people to apply online if possible. The department is getting a lot of applications, and they're not responding very well to phone applications.
他说你可以去是上网申请，他就是建议尽可能的就是上网申请。Okay, 因为这个失业劳工局他们就是不是很快，没办法很快的。太多申请了，他们没办法很快的回复，所以纸质的申请表示没办法是非常慢的。
Unfortunately, non-English speakers may have a hard time with the application. It's not available in, it's only in English and Spanish online. But there's the PLA hotline number here. If you call that number, they can have an interpreter and help you with the application for free.
他就是说好不幸的就是说他们只有个网上申请表只有英文跟西班牙语就是一个是其他语言的 OK 可是他上面有一个 PLA 的热线电话你可以打电话去他们可以找一个翻译给你他就是可以在线上帮你完成这个失业金的申请表。
If you're eligible for unemployment compensation,You'll be automatically eligible for an additional $600 per week under the new Federal CARES Act.
他就是说，如果你是合资格得到这个失业金的话呢，他另外那个联邦的那个 CARE 的那个法案呢，就是另外再加$600一个星期给你，自动的。
The additional $600 per week runs from April 2020 until the end of July.
这个$600是从四月份给你到七月份的。
After you open an unemployment compensation claim, you'll have to file a claim every 2 weeks, to continue to receive benefits.
如果你申请了这个失业金的话，你之后的每两个星期是需要去上网申报的，才可以继续拿到这个失业金的，还有这个$600的。
Once you've exhausted benefits under the new federal law, benefits have been extended by an additional 13 weeks, so you can continue to receive benefits.
他就是说通常因为你拿到这个失业金的话通常是26周可是因为他现在就是宽带了 OK, 所以就是可以再加另外加的13个周就是39周。
And immigrant workers need to have a work authorization to receive benefits. Undocumented immigrants, unfortunately, are not eligible for unemployment.
如果你是移民的工人，移民过来的话，你是需要有一个工作 许可的才可以去申请。如果你是没有完全没有一个合法身份的话，你是没办法可以拿到这一个。
And lastly, the system's very backed up. So if you haven't received your PIN yet, and you have applied, the department is suggesting people reapply. But if not, you should just continue to wait for your PIN, and once you get it, start filing your biweekly claims.
Wait, just want to clarify. So they recommend people to reapply if they did not receive their PIN?
This just came out. If you've applied and it's been more than 3 weeks and you haven't received a PIN, they're encouraging people to reapply at this point.
Wow. So it's going to be even more back up if people keep replying.
Right.
Okay. So 3 weeks, if it's more than 3 weeks, they should reapply. Mm-hmm. They could reapply. Okay. Or they can wait, right?
Yeah. Or they can just continue to wait. And then once they get the PIN, then they should ask for the back pay to the date that they applied.
Okay. 他就是说，所以我要确定一下。他说啥？前两天他们才说了，就是说，因为你三个星期都没有拿到那几个 PIN number 的话，这个密码的话 ，OK， 他就是他们好像劳工局就是建议可以去上网再重新申请。OK， 你可以去重新申请，也可以再等等。OK， 因为你等的话，你当你拿到密码的时候，你可以就是把之前的没有申报的那些州就是一起申报也可以。
Okay, next slide. In addition, the federal government has expanded unemployment to people who are not traditionally eligible for regular unemployment compensation.
就是联邦下来就是有一个叫这个带楼型的失业金，就是讲起来就是 PUA， 基本上就是给哪些正规的失业金不符合这个正规失业金的人去申请的。
The Pandemic Unemployment Assistance Program, so it's available to contractors, gig workers, self-employed folks, business owners, and people who didn't have enough work history to qualify for regular unemployment compensation.
Okay, 这个基本上就是给哪些合约的1099啦，还有就是散工的自雇人士就是商店的这个 owner。然后就是还有就是有一些工人是不够这个工作的那个历史的话，还有就是有的人可能是已经有工作了，可是就是现在病毒就说没有了。
And you can apply for this program if you've lost your job or business, or your hours have been reduced, or you're unable to work for reasons related to coronavirus.
就是如果你是没有工作了 ，OK， 然后还是关门了，然后还有就是那个工时减少，还有就是因为这个病就没办法去上班，都可以去申请。
The benefits can be backdated to January 27th, if the loss of work is related to COVID-19, and the program ends on December 31st of this year.
OK， 这一个计划了，它是可以就是回到去你。最早可以是1月27号也是可以就是到你失业的哪一天 ,OK, 最早的可以回到1月27号然后这个计划是可以到12月31号的。
And the program, like regular unemployment compensation, is for 26 weeks of benefits that can also be extended for 13 weeks, and anyone who gets...PUA will also be eligible for the additional $600 per week from April through July.
每一个也是跟正规的那个失业金一样，就是26周的 ，OK。可是就是加了联邦现在下来的13周，可以到39周了。然后还有就是也可以就是合资格，如果你拿到这个金的话，你也是可以在每个星期多拿600块钱。
This too, PUA application is also available online. So you can apply online, the same website that you would go to for regular unemployment.
这个也是可以上去正规的失业金的网站上去申请的。
The system is a bit glitchy and overly complicated, but so it's taking people about, 3 hours to finish the application right now. So people should set aside a good amount of time to work on the application.
他是说现在这个系统还是有一点点问题，是不一样的申请表， OK？ 可是他说平均来讲，他们有的人要3个小时去完成这个申请表， 所以就是
Folks will have to provide documentation showing self-employment and also showing earnings.
就是你需要提供一些资料，就是证明你是自雇的，还有就是，就是。So
some documents related to self-employment might be any paycheck stubs, bank receipt, 1099, invoices or advertisements from your business are just some examples.
Okay. 这些文件可以是你的工资单啊，还可以是你的银行单啊，也可以是你的有一些可能又是自己开店了，可能是有一些广告啊，就是去证明你自己的这个工作。
And you'll have to upload these documents to on the website, and that can be a bit difficult, but you can do that. You can finish the application and upload the documents later. So it is good to collect these, but if folks have trouble uploading, it shouldn't prevent them from completing the application.
你基本上他说这个文件是需要上载的，所以就是可能比较困难，可是你是可以把这个申请表先填完了。 OK， 之后再回去把这些文件上载也可以，可以是分开的。
OK， next slide.
Okay.
So beyond unemployment compensation, if you've been laid off because of coronavirus, you need to be paid out for all of the hours that you've worked.
他就是说，如果你是因为这个病毒被雇主，就是终止你的工作，就是停止的话，你是可以去把你所得的应得的工资全部拿回来的。And
just as a reminder, the minimum wage in PA is $7.25 per hour. And if you work more than 40 hours in a week, you should get overtime at one and a half of your regular rate.
他就是说基本上在费城的话 ，OK， 最低的工资是7.28块一个小时 ，OK， 如果是多于40个小时的话，一个星期就是应该是1.5倍。
And your employer should give you your final paycheck on or before your next regularly scheduled payday.
他应该是用你离职之前、停职之前，他应该要把你最后一个。 工资单 ，OK， 就是先给你 ，OK， 不可以说等到下一次。
And what I want to talk about here is, go ahead, yeah, I'm good. What I want to focus on here is that employers are required to pay out not only wages but any accrued but unused sick time under the Philadelphia sick leave law, which I'll talk about.
Okay. 他就是说，你停止的话啦 ，OK， 他应该要把所有的公司，包括你还没有用的这个病假，就是那个有薪的假期啊，病假啊，这些应该要全部给你的。Next
slide. So the Philadelphia law requires employers to give their workers sick days.
他说费城的这个法律就是规定是。
These sick days must be paid if there's 10 or more workers, but it can be unpaid if there are 9 or fewer workers. To be eligible for this leave, you have to have worked at least 40 hours per year in Philadelphia.
如果你想受到这个费城的法律保障的话呢，你必须在一年之内有工在费城工作最少40个小时。
And so workers can get, you have to earn the sick leave, so you get 1 hour for every 40 hours that you work, and you can earn up to 40 hours in total.
他就是说 ,OK, 你这个是需要占回来的这个有生病假。OK, 如果你每工作40个小时你可以占到一个小时的病假。总数是最多可以占40个小时。
And there is a waiting period, so you have to have worked 90 days on the job before you can use any earned sick time.
还有就是一个条件，就是说你必须要工作足够有90天了 ，OK， 你才可以开始用这些有生病假。
And Philadelphia has expanded the reason that you can use sick leave. So now if you need to take off of work because there's been a, you're subject to quarantine or an isolation order, or you have symptoms of coronavirus, or you're caring for someone that has coronavirus, or if you need to care for a child who is home because the schools are closed, you can use sick leave for all of these reasons.
Okay.还有就是他现在因为这个病疫情，所以他这个有生病假了条件也放宽了。你可以就是说如果是家里有孩子是需要就看的，还有就是如果你是因为被隔离了 ，OK 其实有生假期都是可以用的。
But most importantly, for people who have been laid off because of coronavirus, employers should be paying out any earned sick time that you haven't used yet. So you should get paid for the days that you haven't used if you're terminated.
他说是说，如果你是被停职了 ，OK 他们是需要吧。
Next slide.
Okay.
If you've been terminated and you are owed wages, or if your employer has not paid you out sick time, you can call CLS for help, the number's there. Or you can go directly to the Philadelphia Mayor's Office of Labor by calling the number at the bottom.
Okay. 他就是说 ,OK, 如果你的工资还有你的这个有生假期就是没有给你的 ,OK, 拖欠的。你可以第一你可以找他们费城法律社区法律部门 ,OK, 就是可以去追讨这些拖欠的工资还有就是有生的假期 ,OK, 它上面有一个电话 ,215-981-3700,OK, 你也可以去直接去费城的市长办公室的劳工部门 ,OK, 办公室就是去追讨下面最下面就是哪个电话号码。
And both CLS and the Mayor's Office of Labor have interpretation services for folks who don't speak English as their primary language.
OK, 这两个机构 OK 都是有翻译可以提供给哪些不讲英语的人的。OK,
okay next slide.So now I'm going to switch over and talk about workers' rights if you're still working.
Okay, 他现在就是讲了，就是说，如果你还在工作了，可是担心这个病毒的话。
Primarily, workers have rights to health and safety at the workplace, paid leave, and if your hours have been reduced, you might also be eligible for unemployment compensation.
他你是就是有权就是这个健康的跟安全的 ,OK, 然后就是还有就是一个有生的病假。
Next slide. So many workers that are still working are very concerned about health and safety at work and are afraid of contracting coronavirus.
Everyone.
安心这个健康的还有安全的问题是关就是关对这个病毒。
So under federal law, all workers have the right to a healthy and safe workplace.
根据这个法律的话，每一个工人都是有权利，就是在一个安全跟健康的环境里边去工作的。
The first question is, should the employer be open? So the Pennsylvania governor has issued a shutdown order, and only life-sustaining businesses should be open. So if you believe that your employer is not a life-sustaining business, you can file a complaint with the Pennsylvania Department of Human Services.
Okay, 就是谁哪一个商业可以就是需要开门呢？根据这个州长的政策，就是说一个就是不需要不是一个需要来维持生那个生活的生命的商业 ，OK 啊，这些是不需要开门的 ，OK
If your employer is permitted to be operating right now, they should be taking safety precautions. So there's guidance from the federal government, from the CDC and OSHA, as to what employers should be doing to protect workers.
如果是开的，必须要开的。OK，他这个雇主是需要做好这些安全的措施。联邦的有一些联邦的，就是规则，就是从 CDC 还有 OSHA 里边都是有说的，需有什么措施。
And at the state level, recently, Pennsylvania, the Department of Health has issued an order, outlining protections for critical workers. And these are required steps that employers should be taking to protect workers at life-sustaining businesses.
然后州政府啦，OK，州政府他已经下命令，就是有一些就是保障，就是这些必须要工作的员工的，OK，在这些必须的行业里边是该怎么做去保障他们的员工的，他们是有一些法令，就是必须要跟着他们做了。
So employers should be reviewing all of this guidance, doing a risk assessment, and taking the proper steps to protect workers.
所以呢，这开门的雇主他们是应该要去看一些这些条令 ，OK， 要跟着这些条令去做，来保障他们的员工的。
Next slide. Some of these things that employers should be thinking about include social distancing in the workplace, like staggering start times, break times, and also making sure that workers are at least 6 feet apart.
第一就是说他们需要就是考虑到就是这个安全的距离。 OK，他们可能把员工就是分班吧，不要全部堆在一起，也有可能就是安排有一些收拾的时间，就是隔开他们工作的时间。Employers
should be making sure that employees, as well as customers coming into the business, have proper protection equipment, such as masks or gloves.
他应该就是必须要保障，就是有员工跟进来的客人都是有戴的些安全的就算手套啊，就是口罩啊，这些设备。Employers
should also be thinking about protocols for customer interaction, whether to install physical barriers to protect workers. And other things such as temperature screenings if there's been confirmed cases of coronavirus at the workplace.
就是他们好呀，需要考虑到就是客人进来的话，怎么跟这个客人接触了？是不是需要安装什么？有一些就是隔离的。OK，还有就是如果他这个店原来就已经是有这个确认的案件的话，他们应该要就是可能就探温吧，探温器。
And finally, another thing to think about is sanitizing workplaces and just making sure that any workers who are coming in contact with cleaning chemicals also have proper safety equipment.
还有就是他们应该要 就是关于清洁方面的 ，OK， 他们应该有一些消毒的，就是工人接触过了 ，OK， 都需应该要需要有消毒的。
Next slide. So what if you're not being protected in the workplace? What can you do?
这里就是说，如果他真的没有保障你们的安全呢，你可以做什么了？
We recommend.When possible, working alongside your coworkers to raise these issues to your employer.
他们是权利，就是建议你们，就是先跟你们的同事 ，OK， 跟你的同事一起把这个担忧 ，OK， 写信 ，OK， 就是跟你的雇主商量。
So it could be a good idea to talk to your employer as a group.Or another thing you could do is write a letter or start an online petition on behalf of a group of workers.
你就是可以就是一组的去跟这个雇主商量 ，OK？ 你可以也可以就是大家写一封信，还有请求信 ，OK？ 验签字 ，OK？ 就是去让这个雇主知道，你可以也可以上网，就是要求领一个表格让大家签字。
And the reason we recommend people work together is not only may you have legal protections from retaliation under health and safety laws, but you also have additional legal protections if you work together to improve your workplace.
他说就是你是有这个权他们你有这个权去跟这个雇主去商讨这些问题 ，OK？ 还有 ，What's the last sentence you said？
So you're protected not only under health and safety laws, but you're protected under the National Labor Relations Act if you work together to improve your workplace.
Okay, 他就是说你除了是受到这个安全跟健康的保障之外，你也就是那个联邦的全国的有一个工人的，就是说如果你们是跟这个你的同事一起去去争取的话，他们也是有一个保障的。
Workers have the right to refuse unsafe working conditions. So if you ask your employer to correct any shortcomings, and they do not correct them, you do have the right to refuse the unsafe work.
他就是说，如果你跟他，如果是不安全的，你有跟你的雇主就是先是就是讨论，有他们就是拒绝去把这个情况改善的话 ，OK， 你是有权去拒绝去上班的。
You should always document any efforts to work with the employer because if you quit because of the unsafe work or you're terminated because you've refused to work in unsafe conditions, you may be eligible for unemployment benefits. So it's good to have documentation.
他说就是如果你是这个情况的话，你最好就是把所有的资料就是可以就是楼底 ，OK， 就是有记录下来。因为如果你是真的因为你就是拒绝去上班，因为这个不安全的工作环境还有就是你被停职了 ，OK， 你是可以去申请这个失业金，可以利用这一个去申请这个失业金的。
And if you need help with raising health and safety issues to your employer, you can always call CLS at the number at the bottom there. We can help either draft letters or help organize workers.
他就是说如果你们是有这个问题的话，你可以跟他们 CLS 联系，他们就是可以帮你们就是起草一封信 ，OK， 跟这个雇主也可以帮你就是组织一下跟这些同事之间的，可以组织一个就是怎么跟这个雇主商量。
Okay, next slide.So beyond health and safety rights, you might also be entitled to paid leave.
Okay, 除了这个安全跟健康的条件，他你还也可以就是这个在病毒期间可以带有薪的休假。
So under a new federal law, workers at employers who have less than 500 employees are eligible for 2 weeks of fully or partially paid emergency sick leave.
根据联邦的法律的话，如果这个雇主是500个工人以下的话， 啊，他们是是可以有两个州的 ，OK， 可以是全包啊，全包帮你付钱啊，就是有声的，全包有声的啊，一个紧急的啊，被你加 ，OK， 啊，有的可能是可能付一点点，可能付一部分的这个紧急的售价病假。
And this federal leave, it's available immediately. Unlike Philly leave, you do not have to accrue it, and there's no waiting period.
Okay, 这个是联邦法律的 ，Okay， 你不需要去站的，不需要说啊要多少做40个啊，然后才可以拿一个小时的。这个是现在都已经啊，联邦法律是现在病毒是生效的。
And this is in addition to the Philadelphia sick leave.
这个是加在这个费城的病假的条例上面的。
So workers essentially might be eligible for 2 weeks of sick leave under the federal law, and then may have up to 1 week of paid or unpaid sick leave under Philadelphia law.
费城的法律，因为这个病毒的法律就是说可以最多可以最多拿到一个星期的这个。
In addition,
病假啊，可以有可能有，有可能是有薪的，有可能是没有工资的。
In addition, the new federal law has expanded family and medical leave. So workers may have an additional 10 weeks of partially paid leave if they need to stay home to care for a child whose school or care provider has closed because of coronavirus.
另外呢，因为家庭还有他们增加了一个就家庭跟医疗的休假。OK， 他因为你孩子的学校是关门了 ，OK， 他可以再加多10个周。
And this pay is going to go for the expanded family and medical leave. If you're using that 10 weeks to stay home to care for a child, it's paid at two-thirds of your regular rate.
Okay. 他说就是如果是这个增加了这个新增的这个家庭的收假 okay, 他说有十个周里边是不是正常工资的，是三分之二的工资的。
And the only requirement for this expanded family medical leave is that you must have worked at least 30 days for your employer.
他就是说有一个条件，就是你必须为这个雇主工作起码要30天以上的。
And there's no immigration-related restrictions on eligibility, so you're entitled to the sick leave and the expanded family and medical leave, regardless of your immigration status.
Okay, 这些是没有说有身份没有身份的 ，Okay， 不管你是什么身份，你都是可以选有这些就是病假，还有就是家庭跟医疗的假期。
Next slide.So what can you use this leave for?
这一个就是说这个可以用来做什么了。
You're able to use the sick leave, if you're unable to work, because you or a family member, you care for are subject to a quarantine or isolation order, if a healthcare provider has told you or a family member to self-quarantine,if you have coronavirus symptoms and you're seeking a diagnosis from a doctor, or if you are caring for a child whose school or care provider is closed.
Okay, 这个就是可以用来就是如果你没办法工作，因为以下的原因，第一就是说，如果你跟你家庭家里的人 ，Okay, Okay, 如果你还是你家里的人是需要隔离了 ，OK， 就是被确认说可能有怀疑还是确认了需要被隔离的 ，OK。还有就是如果你有一个医生 ，OK 健康的提供的 ，OK， 就是告诉你你们需要在家里隔离 ，OK。还有就是你有这个病毒的那个叫什么 symptom， 就是怀疑你有这个病毒了 ，OK。你要去找这个找人看 ，OK。 啊，还有就是你就是孩子的学校关门了，你需要在家里照看孩子。
And generally, this federal leave, it's fully paid if you're taking leave to care for yourself, and it's going to be paid at 2/3 your regular rate if you're taking leave to care for a family member or a child.
Okay, 这个如果是这个这个联邦的这个假期 ，OK， 是100% 付给你自己，因为你自己需要隔离 ，OK。啊，还有就是，如果啊，如果你是因为要照顾家庭的人的话，就是三分之二。
Next slide. A lot of folks have asked if their employer can force them to use their paid time off.
啊，有的人就是说，这个雇主可不可以强逼这些工人现在这个时间用这些带薪的休假？
Under the new federal law, employers are prohibited from requiring employees to use their existing paid time off before the emergency sick leave or the expanded family and medical leave.
Before, 在之前有这个紧急，刚才他说的这个病假紧急的病假，还有就是。增加的家庭跟医疗的休假和联邦法律之前而且这雇主是严更不准不许可不允许去强逼工人用这些休假的。
And generally, workers cannot be forced to use accrued paid time off against their will.
Okay, 还有就是经常来说的话呢工人是没不可以强逼这些工人就是之前说的有的有的这些有薪假期是你自己去占的嘛40个工作 hour 就可以有一个小时的这些占了你如果你不想的话他们没办法强逼你去用把它用完。
We've heard that some employers are telling employees that they have to use all of their paid time off before they can apply for unemployment compensation. This is not true. You don't have to exhaust PTO before applying.
之前呢，有的人就是说，你必须把这些 PTO 就是有薪假期用完了，才可以申请这个失业金。是不需要的，这个是错的。
But if you do receive PTO while you're collecting unemployment, you would just report any PTO that you're paid in your biweekly.
可是如果你雇主现在是给这个有薪休假的钱给你的 ，OK？ 你申请你这个返网申报的时候，你要跟他们说你是有拿到这个有薪工资的。
And if workers are having problems.Figuring out if they're entitled to leave or if their employer has denied them leave that they think that they're entitled to and they can come to CLS for assistance.
如果你就是不知道究竟你有没有这些有薪休假还是他们跟你说你没有可是你不确认的话 OK 你就是可以找 CLS.
Just briefly I'm going to talk about workers' compensation. Workers may be eligible for workers' compensation benefits if you're exposed to COVID-19 in the workplace. But it's going to be very hard to make up these claims.
如果你是在工作期间 ，OK， 可能就是可能旁边有些是病毒被有病毒 ，OK， 你有可能可以追讨这些工人的补偿。
To make a workers' compensation claim, you'd have to provide evidence that you were exposed to coronavirus in the workplace. And this is just going to be very difficult to prove. Where and how you got sick when the virus really is everywhere. So we expect that employers are going to challenge a lot of workers' compensation.
这个可是这个是比较有一点困难，因为是你需要很多证据去证明你在工作期间得到这个病毒，可能是暴露住在这个病毒的。OK， 因为这个病毒是哪里都有了现在 ，OK， 所以很难去证明这个。并就是在你工作期间得到的。
And lastly, I just want to remind everyone that if you're still working, but your hours have been reduced, you can apply for partial unemployment benefits, and also partial pandemic unemployment assistance.
他就是说，如果你的工时被减少了，可以减一部分的失业金，还是这个 PUA 都可以的。